If 10 million fireflies lit up the world as I fell asleep. Cause they fill the open air and leave teardrops everywhere. You'd think me rude, but I would just stand and stare. Cause I get 1,000 hugs from 10,000 lightning bugs as they tried to teach me.
With what to do now. That took me about a week and it got squished down into 3 minutes.
Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to Titan Crafters episode, here we go, can't remember. We've made a witch farm, me and Princess have made a witch farm. We did the whole lot on the stream. You probably won't see me building any of this in any of the episodes because it was on the stream. Anyway, we've actually got two witch spawns here. We've got a natural one, and we've got a modded one. So we've got one from a witch hut, and we've got one up here somewhere from the extra structures mod that we've got going on. You know, we're not 100% vanilla. Don't get your wires crossed, guys. Yeah, and all the drops come up here, up this redstone elevator here, and they come across, and it is doing pretty darn well, I must admit. I think I went AFK overnight, and I did get kicked, so I can't give you exacts. But imagine your normal witch drops plus having a witch spawner. Yeah, see, all the potions are filled up. It's and then we got the overflow, obviously. And this was my little genius idea. Because we're in a swamp. I got four golems around here, stood on the cactuses. Cactuses? Fucking cactuses, Rick. Shit. Yeah. So we're getting slimes too. I use glow lichen because it only gives off a light level of 7. And believe it or not, slimes on the surface of a swamp in the right lunar phase will only spawn under light level 7. Whereas if you're in a slime chunk under that certain threshold, they'll spawn at any light level. I was very, very close to just putting jack-o'-lanterns around this whole thing, and I wouldn't have got a single slime. I'm glad I did my research before that. But anyway, we have a witch farm. We've got unlimited supplies of redstone, glowstone, and we've got the added bonus of a bit of slime. There you can see that, where I'm pointing it at right now, that is the natural witch spawn from the witch hut. And then about maybe 10 blocks above, that is a witch spawner from our modded version of the game. So yeah, cool.
If you hadn't noticed at the start of the video, we actually built the moon as well. Me and the princess spent pretty much the entire evening absolutely destroying a coral reef. I think we came away with about 2 shulker boxes worth of different colored corals, and we only needed about 3 stacks, really. Hey ho. That's all you need to build the moon, apparently. And I built the moon on the live stream. If you're not familiar with any of my live streams, please do go check them out. You'll pretty much see everything behind the scenes, behind the videos, just all of that jazz, plus, you know, being part of our team, part of the community, whatever, I don't know what to say. Just go check out my live streams. Harley also plays a massive role, but you've got to watch it to find out. And now that I'm done plugging myself, let's have a look at this thing properly, shall we? Still up in arms about Earth. I think it could be a massive villager breeder plus trading hall. The moon is the worst, the moon. There's not really fuck all I can put in there. There's not enough room really to do anything, I don't think, just yet. Anyway, I don't know, maybe if we get a few more subscribers we can do something special in there, but that's the solar system so far, so good. Do I end the video now or do I carry on? I'm not sure. What a landing. What the fuck is this? Okay, we've got a prankster that doesn't realize this planet relies on a mob cap to actually work. I will deal with that later. This is the inside of Earth. See, we've got a fair amount of room, I'd say. Nowhere near as big as some of the other planets we've built, but we can easily get a villager breeder and a trading hall in there. I still don't think I can do anything with the moon just yet, but we'll work on it. We will work on it. Well, guys, I'm going to have to call that the end of the episode. Unfortunately, YouTube's kind of been a bit funny with me recently, so I'm trying all different avenues and different things, so shorter videos hopefully will do a bit better. I don't know. Fingers crossed, we'll see what happens. Either way, come catch me in a live stream. Other than that, peace out, have a good day. See you all later.